I don't know how dangerous they are for Gordon, you know. There's just a big weight discrepancy in front of.
Hey guys, can you keep it down a little bit, please? I'm talking about myself. Hey.
I was going through this whole ADCC thinking like, man, is this the pinnacle? Is this it?
Jiu-jitsu fans, I have a very special guest. It's PJ Barge. How you doing? You just taught a great class.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, we're over here at Alliance in La Mesa in San Diego. This is our kind of temporary spot for the time being. And yeah, just building the guys, getting some new guys in, and it's been fun.
Because you've been so focused on ADCC stuff, but I know you have your own gym coming up, I think in downtown Chula Vista.
Yeah, I signed the lease on the spot like almost 2 years ago, so it's been a long time. This past year, I decided to really focus in on jiu-jitsu and my training schedule and stuff like that. And then since ADCC, it's been just balls to the wall, building the gym. I want to have it like perfect. I want to have my schedule perfect. I want the gym to be perfect.
Hey, guys, keep it down.
And I want everything to be smooth sailing. And then by like Q2 of this year, I want to start competing again for sure.
Okay, so when you talk about competing, is it strictly jiu-jitsu stuff, or could we ever see like combat jiu-jitsu in there?
Combat jiu-jitsu, yeah. I mean, I signed on for this most recent one for Eddie. It's fun for me, but again, like it would be like a pretty insane preparation for that. I'd want to be in like really tip-top shape, you know. If you're really, you know, risking my brain and stuff like that, I want to be. I love the stuff. It's exciting to me, but yeah, it's fun. It's a fun format for me. I like it a lot.
Yeah, and I definitely thought the last one was so entertaining with B-Team going up against 10th Planet in the finals. Your style is obviously not very much like Ben Eddy's with all the rubber guard stuff, but how cool is it to watch that stuff? And do you ever, like, incorporate that in your game in regular roles, or are you just straight up, like, wrestling, looking for the back all the time?
Well, you know, when I first started training jiu-jitsu, I was pretty heavy on my back. It's what I did most of the time. You know, I instinctively wrestled and things like that, and I could grapple well. But all of my coaches, Nathan Orchard, Boogie, were 10th Planet guys in jiu-jitsu. So they were heavy on their backs and heavy with rubber guard and stuff like that. So I played a lot of rubber guard and stuff back then. Now I've had to focus in my game a little bit differently, especially with ADCC preparation and things like that. And for my coaching, I prefer this, especially if I'm coaching MMA athletes and stuff like that. I prefer to have a good, strong wrestling base. And passing is something that I neglected for so many years in the beginning that I wanted to like really focus in on. So I've been, you know, focusing on getting really good at passing, because I can't just take people down and not pass their guard, you know?
Yeah. And when it comes to, I'm really scared this isn't recording. Okay, it is recording. Just wanted to be sure. When you look at ADCC, you beat JT Torres in the very opening round. Maybe people were doubting you coming in because he was the reigning champ coming in. So is that one of, you know, the highest points in your career, you would say? Or is it kind of just like, another win for you?
Of course, yeah. Beating JT was a big one. I don't want to, like, die on that hill that JT, you know what I mean? Like, I always... Alex, I firmly believe that I could beat anybody on any given day in jiu-jitsu. You know what I mean? Beating JT was a big accomplishment for me.
Hey, guys, can you keep it down a little bit, please? I'm talking about myself. Hey. Guys, I'm talking about myself. Keep it down a little bit.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
He's talking about himself.
I'm trying to stroke my ego here. yeah. Beating JT was a big highlight, but I knew that I could beat JT, you know? I knew that he would be a challenge, but I firmly believe that I can beat just about anybody in ADCC rules.
If you are enjoying this video, don't forget to hit like, and if you're not already a subscriber, subscribe too. Thank you guys for 3,000, and on
to the
interview.
Getting all these people that have been doing jiu-jitsu since they were 4 years old. So what is it about their game that is just so great and it's hard to keep them pinned down?
Those guys are like, it's almost like if you grapple with like you know how like if you're a really experienced grappler and you grapple with a white belt and they're doing crazy things that you're like it doesn't make sense in your jiu-jitsu head. That's what it's like, except they're extremely talented black belts. You know, they're really, really good at what they do, and they've been training for so long, and you don't know what's gonna come when, and you know what you're reacting to and what you're grappling against. It's like, you know, you're playing almost like a different sport, it feels like, sometimes with them. And so it can be a quite a tricky situation to be in, and you don't want to ever make mistakes. They never stop moving. It's hard to slow them down in any one position. Well, especially Cade. It's hard to slow Cade down. It's hard to keep him pinned in any one position. And it's you know, you're not going to control them too much. There's just a lot of energy, a lot of movement, and they're just so squirmy and talented. And they're going to capitalize on any mistake, anything you leave behind, any arm. You know what I mean? You can't even be safe in side control, apparently. You know what I mean? So it's they're dangerous from everywhere. You know, so.
Very exciting. I know the next year of ADCC will be even bigger, probably at T-Mobile Arena per Mo's ADCC live chats. When you look to the future, I know there's a lot of talk about Gordon Ryan and everything he's doing and Cade calling him out. When you look at those matchups, do you just kind of laugh at the Rotolo brothers for calling him out? Or are you like, okay, you can actually see them taking on Gordon?
I mean, I think that they would, you know what I mean? I think that they probably would. I don't know if that's, I don't know how dangerous they are for Gordon, you know? There's just a big weight discrepancy, and Gordon's very skilled, you know? I don't doubt at all that they would challenge him and go do it, yeah.
And I saw one post where you were like, hopefully Craig Jones stops ducking me. And I wasn't sure if you guys were already friends or something. And then you guys ended up rolling together. So was it just like a friendly, like, stop ducking me? Or was it like, I actually want to like roll with you hard and see who's better?
Craig is just, Craig's just a lot of fun. You can fuck around with Craig and he doesn't take hard feelings and things like that. So I was just
really, I feel like if you tried to steal Gabby Garcia, he would get really upset with you.
Yeah, that might be true. Yeah, he's got a thing for her.
Well, this is some serious tea that we're getting. ADCC is going to be a big one. Do you have any final things that you want to let the fans know about you? I know you have the big gym opening coming up, but what else is on the horizon for PJ Barch in 2023?
No, like I said, right now I'm just preparations for the gym opening up. I'm still working on my skills and I'm still getting better and things like that. I honestly believe that I'm the best I've ever been, and that when I get back into competition shape and I start competing towards like the mid half of this year or something like that, people are going to see, because people are going to forget for a little bit. They have short memories in this sport, but I'm just really excited to ramp back up in the ADCC again and then, you know, really make my stamp by 2024.
I love it. Well, you definitely made me interested in ADCC this year. This is my first year ever really watching anything ADCC, but I feel like this is kind of like the growing of jiu-jitsu. I never really understood why everyone was so obsessed about it, but everything Mo is doing and like just the spectacle of it, it's becoming so much greater. So is it kind of nice at this point of your career, it's really taking off and you're also like, not peaking, but you're like getting close to like what could be, you know, the climax to this.
Yeah, Mo has really transformed things. You know what I mean? I was going through this whole ADCC thinking like, man, is this the pinnacle? Is this it? Like, is it all downhill from here? You know what I mean? Did I experience the best of jiu-jitsu? But I don't think that that's the case. And it seems that we're only going up from there, and there's a big credit to Mo for that, and just for having like kind of very clear motives about what he wants to do and how he wants to build these things, and really putting a plan into action. You know, I'm really impressed with his work ethic and the way that he gets things done, and you know, and the way he sticks to his word on things, and the transparency that Mo operates under, and. I think that he's pivotal for the sport in this moment, and ADCC is as well, for sure.
I love it. Yeah, when he was saying he wasn't going to do it another year, I was just like, what? No way. So I'm happy to see him back. ADCC 2024 will be on UFC Fight Pass. I'm sure PJ Barch will make waves in it, probably be ADCC champ over here. We can't wait to see it. Thank you so much, PJ. Thanks.